Imagine your HMI coming to life. Your motor lights up when it runs, fades when it stops, and your elements move just like in the real plan. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to make that happen using animation in Siemens TIA Portal step by step. Let's get started and make your HMI come alive. Before we animate anything, we need an object to work with. I'll add a circle to the screen as a motor indicator. This will represent our real motor in the process. You can use a circle, a rectangle, or any symbol from the library. I'll also place a small text label here to keep things clear for the operator. I'll call it motor. Now that we have our motor indicator on the screen, let's connect it to our PLC data so it can react to what's happening in the program. I already have a data block in my PLC called DB motor with variables like motor on shows when the motor is running, motor overload goes through if there is a fault, and target position. We'll use this later for movement. Back on the HMI screen, I select the circle we added. In the properties window, I go to the animation section. Under display, I click add new animation. Let's begin with appearance. This animation changes how an object looks, like its color or flashing behavior based on a tag value. It's great for showing status, for example, when a motor is running or stopped. Here I connect the motor on tag to the appearance property. I just drag the variable directly from the PLC data block into the tag field. TIA Portal automatically creates the HMI tag and links it to the PLC. Then choose the color. I set it so that when the tag is true, the color changes to green. And when it's false, it goes back to gray. And that's it. Let's test it in simulation. Download the project to the PLC. Let's start the motor, modify the value to 1. As soon as the bit goes high, the lamp lights up green. And when it goes low, it fades back to gray. So far, we have made an object change color based on a simple on-off tag. But you can take this even further. You can also change an object's appearance depending on a numeric value, not just a bit. This is useful when your tag represents levels or steps like speed, temperature zones, or pressure range. Let's make a quick example. I insert another circle. This one will represent a temperature indicator. Then I go to animations, add new animation, appearance. For the tag connection, I'm going to create a new integer variable in my DB. Let's call it temp value. Under the column configuration, we can define value range. For example, between 0 and 5 make the object blue, indicating it's cold. Between 6 and 11 change it to green, normal temperature. And 12 and above make it red, showing over temperature. If you want to make a state more visible, you can also turn on flashing in the same place. For example, when the value goes over the limit, not only change it to red, make it flash. That way the operator won't miss it, because flashing always attracts attention. Now when we run the simulation, watch what happens. As the tag value increases, the object automatically changes color depending on which range it falls into. At low values, it's blue, cold. As it rises into the normal range, it turns green. And once it gets too high, it switches to red and flashing. This is perfect for showing different states with a single tag, like speed zones, pressure level, or even tank fill stages. Now let's look at one important detail inside the appearance setting, the type option. Under type, you'll see three modes: range, multiple bit, and single bit. Each one defines how TIA interprets the tag value to decide which appearance to show. Let's quickly go over what each type means. Range is used for numeric tags like integer or reals. You define one or more value intervals, and each range can have a different color or appearance, just like we did for the temperature example. Multiple bits is for bit-based values like a byte or a word, where several bits might be active at once. You can define which combination of bits triggers a certain appearance. I'll use a simple rectangle as our indicator again. I'm going to create a new variable. Let's say our PLC sends a byte called motor mode. Add appearance, link it to the tag motor mode, and under type choose multiple bits. Now define a few conditions for how it should look depending on which bits are active. For example, when bit 0 manual mode is on, make it blue. When bit 1 automatic mode is on, make it green. And when bit 2 fault mode is on, make it red. Let's test it in simulation. When I turn on bit 0, the color switches to blue, manual mode. Be careful, the DB displays the value here in hexadecimal format. Turn that off and activate bit 1. It changed to green, automatic mode. And if I set bit 2, it turns red, showing a fault condition. This is a great way to visualize multiple system states without adding extra animations. Now that we've seen how multiple bit works, let's look at single bit, the simplest and most common option. While multiple bits checks combination of bits, single bit focuses on just one bit inside your tag, like a switch or a single condition. We use the same motor mode byte from before. This time I'll add another small object and add new animation. Appearance, link it to the same tag motor mode. Under type, select single bit. Now we choose which bit we want this object to react to. For example, bit 2, default bit. We set the appearance so when bit 2 is 0, color is gray, and when bit 2 is 1, color is red. Let's test it in simulation. I'll toggle just speed 2 of motor mode. When it's off, the circle stays gray. As soon as I turn B2 on, it turns red immediately. This is the easiest way to show a specific condition from a multi-bit tag. For example, a fault light, a mode indicator, or a sensor alarm. Because it's based on a single bit, it reacts instantly and doesn't depend on any other bits in the same tag. Alright, now that our motor lamp, the mode and temperature indicator are all reacting to the PLC, let's make the HMI buttons a bit smarter. Sometimes you don't want a button to always be active. For example, when the motor is already running, you don't want the operator to press the start button again. That's exactly what the control enable animation does. It lets you enable or disable an object based on a tag value. I've already created a simple project to start and stop a motor. Add two buttons, label one start, the other stop. For the start button, link the press event to motor start set bit. And link the release event to motor start reset bit. This way, when the button is pressed, the start bit becomes true, and when it's released, it goes back to zero. Do the same for the stop button, but link it to the stop tag. If you'd like more information about events, watch our video on TIA Portal HMI events. Select the start button on your HMI screen. In the Properties panel, go to Animation, Add New Animation, Control Enable. Now link it to the same motor on tag we used earlier. Then set the condition to enable when the motor on is false. This means when the motor is off, the button can be pressed, but as soon as it starts running, the button will automatically disable. Let's also make that visual by slightly dimming the button when it's disabled. You can adjust this from the appearance setting. Alright, let's try it out. Download the change. Start the HMI simulation again. Turn on the motor with the start button. As soon as the motor on tag goes through, the start button grays out and you can't press it anymore. I'm pressing the start button, but it doesn't get the true value because it's disabled. Turn the motor off again and the button reactivates. That's a perfect example of how Control Enable keeps your interface safe and user-friendly. By the way, Control Enable also supports single bit, just like Appearence. If you enable or disable, logic comes from a status word, for example, motor mode or system status. You can choose a single bit. Pick the bit index and the button will be enabled only when that bit is true. If you need the opposite behavior, simply invert the condition. Now let's make the HMI a little bit more dynamic. The visibility animation lets us show or hide objects depending on a tag value. This is perfect for alarm, warning, or any temporary information you only want to see sometimes. Let's try it with a simple example. The motor overload indicator. On the screen from equipment, automation and states, add a caution icon. We call this one motor alarm. Go to Animations, add new animation, Visibility. For the tag connection, select Motor Overload. Now set it so the object is visible when the tag is true. That means this caution icon will appear only when the overload is active. Let's test it again in simulation. Go to your PLC data block and set motor overload to true. Right away, the red indicator appears on your HMI. Set it back to false and it disappears. Like appearance and control enable in TIA Portal, visibility can also work in two different modes, range and single bit. With range, the object is visible or invisible only when the tag value is between two numbers. For example, visible when the level is between 50 and 80. With single bit, the visibility depends on one specific bit inside the tag. So instead of looking at whole number, it checks a single bit position. Visibility is one of the most common animations you'll use. It keeps your screens clean and only shows what's important at the right time. Now it's time for one of the most fun parts, movement animation. This lets your HMI objects move smoothly across the screen based on a tag value, perfect for things like tank levels, slider, or valve positions. Let's add a simple example. On the screen, from equipment, infrastructure, and vehicles, I press a car icon. Now I select the car, go to Properties, Animations, Movement, Horizontal Movement. For the tag connection, I'll use the variable target position. Set the range from 0 to 500 to match the tag value. Next, define your start and end positions. For example, the car starts at X 10 and Y 250. And as the value increases, it moves horizontally across the screen to the target position. You can also drag the icon on the screen and set the start and end positions. Let's test it out in simulation. Open the DB and gradually increase the movement value. As the values goes up, the car moves across the screen. That's how simple it is to turn your static graphics into live process visuals. You can also use movement in other directions, vertical, diagonal, or direct, using the same steps. In this video, we learned that with just a few animations, you can bring your HMI screens to life in Siemens TIA Portal. From simple color change to visibility control and even full motion driven by your PLC data. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helped you understand how to use animations effectively in your own project. See you in the next video. Bye.